I want to update a perspective on British equity prices that I don't think gets nearly enough attention. And the thought process behind the chart I'm going to put up here in a second is that obviously nominal stock prices are quoted in pounds, in euros, and in dollars. And because currencies, they're no longer tied to anything real, they lose value year after year, I think what we're getting is a distorted view of the real world value of equities. And so this chart I'm putting up now is kind of an attempt to show equities in terms of a more stable benchmark. So all we're doing here is plotting the nominal FTSE that gets quoted every day in the financial papers, but then we're also adjusting nominal stock prices in two ways. First by the producer price index, and then in terms of gold. And so what kind of picture is emerging here? Well, when priced in gold, you know, stocks are back to levels that were last seen in, you know, the 1980s, right? You know, some people look at a chart like this and say, you know, gold's a relic. It's lost its place in modern day finance. I disagree with these arguments. Oh, gold has maintained its value for millennia. It will continue to do so. And the picture it paints of stocks is frankly kind of stunning, right? Stock market appreciation is largely an illusion that is created by the declining value of the currency unit, the pound in this case. Now, the picture isn't quite as bleak in terms of producer prices, but it's still pretty bleak, right? The FTSE peaked in terms of the PPI back in 1999. It made two lower peaks since then, one in the late 2000s, another in 2017. Personally, I really like to track this version of the FTSE PPI, because I think it really captures the average investor's experience in terms of the physical goods that we all kind of, you know, strive to achieve in modern society. And, you know, on that basis, equity prices have lost, 40% of their value in two decades. It's pretty stunning to me, honestly. And every time I update this chart, I just kind of get shocked all over again. But now, even if we look at the nominal FTSE, right? So this is the most optimistic picture of British stocks. Top chart doesn't account at all for the declining value of the pound. Even here, equities have been a fairly terrible performer. You do the math, the FTSE's up about 6% since the top back in 1999. So we've had more than two decades of ups and downs and 6% to show for it in nominal terms. And again, two decades of outright losses when adjusted for inflation. So again, I think it's these charts that should get updated every day in the papers, because they paint a much different picture of stock performance. And now we're obviously only talking about Britain here, but this kind of analysis, it applies to continental Europe, it applies to the United States. And the takeaway again is that we get a very distorted picture of equities if we only look at them nominally.